Howdy, I'm Bob Terry, and welcome to another free Western brought to you here on the internet by Wild West Toys. Up next is a fantastic, fun, exciting Western. It's a Roy Rogers movie starring Roy Rogers, Dale Evans, and our friend Don Reynolds is in it. It's his first movie. The movie's titled The Yellow Rose of Texas. Of course, there's suspense, there's mystery, there's adventure, there's excitement, and some of the best Western music ever done by Roy, by Dale, and by the Sons of the Pioneers. Don is pretty well retired now, lives here in Texas, and he was good enough to come by and talk with us sometimes about different things, and we're going to show, before the movie starts, we're going to show some tidbits with Don about the movie, and make sure that you stay all the way to the end, because after the movie, we're going to talk with Don a little bit more. Don, tell us some more about Roy Rogers. Your first movie that you were in, what was the first movie you were in with Roy?
Called Yellow Rose of Texas. And because of me, they found the wreck that had happened a year ago and all the gold and saved the picture.
Well, so you're very important.
Yes. No, being a kid, I had a slingshot and I automatically just shooting around, and I shot a team of horses that was pulling my wagon, and they took off, and then Roy had to run and rescue me, and then the wagon went over the cliff, and that's whenever it did, they went down and found the wreck of the one that had been there years before that supposedly had the treasure on it.
And Don, you worked with Roy in how many movies?
I did two movies with him. One, my first movie was with him, and that was called The Yellow Rose of Texas, and then later on I did a little one-scene thing with him where I roped a calf. I was about 7 or 8 years old at the time, and it was called Song of Arizona. And but Roy was almost like a neighbor, because his horse trainer, Glenn Randall, lived right next door to us, and so I saw an awful lot of him, and we rodeoed together and whatever. And Roy was just, well, if it hadn't been for him, I wouldn't be here today, because he brought me to California in 1944, or 43, and got me started in movies, and I wound up being the Last Little Beaver, and got into the business, basically. I became an animal trainer, and I trained horses for Lord of the Rings. It was my biggest thing I ever did, and anyway, that because of Roy, I would have not done all that. So everything I got, I owe him.
Feeling?
Me? I'm feeling fine.
Know where we're playing tomorrow?
Yes, I know. Prairie City.
Well, I thought maybe you might not want to face them up there. So I'll put another act in your place and you sort of take it easy, huh?
That's not necessary, Cap. It's been 5 years. They've probably forgotten about it anyway. You've got something else on your mind, haven't you?
It's about your father, Betty.
What about him?
He's broken jail.
Did they get him?
No, he's still out. Happened about a week ago. I read it in the Prairie City paper. I'm sorry, darling, but you have to know it sometime.
I'm sorry, too. You shouldn't have done it, Cap.
Well, there's no use worrying about that now. But you see what I meant when I said about taking the day off tomorrow? Might be a little embarrassing.
Embarrassing? Why should it be?
Well, they're liable to have a little hard feeling about you up there, on account of your father, I mean. And I just sort of figured
that... That's all the more reason I should face them, Cap. We've got nothing to be ashamed of. You think I'd let you down?
Well, as a matter of fact, Betty, what you're doing is exactly what I expected you to do. Now you go and hit the hay, old trooper.
Yes, sir.
You look worried.
Maybe I am, a little. Have you ever been in Prairie City?
No, this is my first trip. You're going to have to show me around. I sort of dread strange places.
I think I know what you mean. I dread it, too.
But I thought you knew the place.
That's just the trouble. I do.
City. Maybe 2 or 3 hours. It's going to be awful hard getting on board until after dark, Mr. Weston.
Tonight will be all right. I'll give you a note. Be sure Betty gets it.
But don't let anybody see you give it to her. You understand?
Folks, get your tickets here for the greatest show that ever hit Prairie City. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Get your tickets here. Get your tickets here for the greatest show that ever hit Prairie City. It's just about to start, folks. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Get your tickets here. Just a minute, gentlemen. Get your tickets here.
Official business.
Take over, Lou.
All right, Cap.
All right, folks. Step right up and get your...
You seen anything? Not yet, Sheriff. I know everybody that's come aboard so far.
I still don't think he'd risk coming up here. It's a sucker move.
Weston's no sucker. He's sharp. He figures he'll be safer in the crowd than trying to make it alone. I know that guy.
Well, keep your eyes open, boys.
How many are you, sir? Four? Yes, sir. All right, sir. Step right along, please. There's plenty of tickets and plenty of room. Thank you, sir. All right, lady, how many?
there's a yellow rose in Texas I'm going there to see. No other fella knows her, no other, only me. She cried so when I left her, it broke her loving heart. And if we ever meet again, we'll never, never part. She's the rose of rarest beauty this fellow ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may sing of other pretty gals from Maine to Tennessee, but the yellow rose of Texas is the only rose for me.
There's a cowboy back in Texas who said he would be true.
I knew you were from Texas.
Please tell me how you knew.
The way you smile reminds me of the one I used to know.
There's a many a rose in Texas if you're looking where they grow.
There's a cowboy back in Texas.
Well, he's really just a friend. He lived down by the Rio where the river makes a bend.
Well, you know my rose of Texas lives across on the other shore.
So as long as they're together, we won't see them anymore. He's the rose of rarest beauty this fellow ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may sing of other pretty gals from Maine to Tennessee, but the certain one of Texas is the only.
How do you do, Sheriff? You wanted to see me?
I'd like to ask you a few questions. When did you hear from your father last?
Well, about a month ago he wrote me a letter. But I think I know what you want me to say.
But you tell us.
That I know where he is. I'm sorry, Sheriff, but he didn't let me in on his plans.
You were figuring on seeing him, weren't you?
Absolutely not.
There's no particular reason you should tell us if you did know.
In that case, Sheriff, why do you bother to ask?
Just a minute, young lady. If you know what's good for you, if you want to save yourself from trouble, you talk. And talk fast.
Simmer down, mister. You're getting out of line fast.
You too, cowboy. Suppose you mind your own affairs.
How do you know this isn't my affair?
Please, Roy. I can handle it.
Oh, that's an idea. Beat it.
Do you mind? I'd like to talk to the sheriff alone.
You better stay here, Gus.
Long distance, please. I'd like to place a call to Mr. John Ellis, National Insurance Company in Dallas.
Hello, Roy. How are you doing? Did you contact the girl?
Yes, sir. I got a job on the showboat as an entertainer. I have a hunch she doesn't know anything about the missing money, though.
Well, I hope your hunch is wrong, Roy. But handle it your own way. Stick close to her. I still say that she and her father will try to get together. Right.
In a hurry, mister?
I could be. Why?
Nothing. Only it might be a good idea. As a matter of fact, I make a... You leave town right away.
And I second it. You wouldn't want to get that nice shirt all dirty. It's too pretty.
Well, I'm glad you like it. But don't worry about it getting dirty. I have to take things to the cleaners every once in a while.
I like your scarf, too. That's a little uneven.
Hey, bouncer! Bouncer! Touchdown!
Throw these fellas out of here.
With pleasure, boss.
Roy!
Buster!
You old son of a gun, how you been?
Well, how you been?
Here, I said, throw him out. You mean Roy, Mr. Gorse? I can't do that. He's my pal. I haven't seen
him
in years.
What's that got to do with it? You're fired.
Come on, baby. Keeping you busy?
Sure, on the move every minute. Take us, heel a bend, rodeo or two, round up, all the usual topics, Buster.
It's a great life.
Sure is.
Just a minute. Yes. Hey! Hey! I'll give you a...
Now, who started this? Him.
Me?
All right, arrest him.
Which way did they go?
It was mighty nice of you fellas pitching in and helping me like that.
No problem at all.
We couldn't stand by and see one fella gang up on like that.
I guess we better go in and see if the boss is back yet, huh?
Yeah, about our job.
Job?
Sure.
Yeah, they sent for us to play and sing in here.
Oh, musicians, huh?
You fellas ain't got any job. That was the boss Roy and I slugged.
Do we do now?
Well, we might as well hightail it back over the ridge where we came from.
Hey, maybe Roy can get you a job in a showboat. How about it, Roy?
All of them?
Well,
wait a minute, fellas. I don't own the boat. I'd like to.
Come on, Roy. We can't let them down. Where's your instruments?
Well, at the express office where we shipped them, I guess.
Well, come on, let's go.
Wait a minute. Where's Shub?
Shub?
Yeah.
Say, you don't suppose he...
Hey! Little boy!
Take that thing!
Get him out of there! Stop! Can't get it off him! Tim! Bob! Help me here! Somebody get down with him! Well! Hey!
Let's go get the instruments.
We're the Sons of the Pioneers. We came after our instruments.
Yeah, that'll be 480.
Sam, Shub.
Thanks, Shub.
Our banker.
Hey.
Don't beat yourself to death. Hey, now, wait a minute. Don't tell me you lost all our dough in that fight.
I sure did. It's gone.
Still 480. That's all right, fellas. I'll stick it.
Remember, now, this is just a loan. We'll pay you back. Okay, pick him up, boys.
Wait a minute, fellas. How about getting your instruments out and playing us a tune? We want to see how good you are.
You mean right here?
Sure.
Well, all right, boys.
I'm coming home.
I've been away, but there'll come a day, so darling, don't you cry.
I'm coming
here
home.
Comes your rover coming home.
I'm coming.
Howdy, Cap.
Hey, what sort of a fish do you call this?
Pretty good, huh?
Here comes your rover coming home.
I'm coming
back home. To the open range and roping one little gal I knew.
I'm coming
back
home.
To the wave and sage and saving all my love for you.
I'm coming
open the
so folks, just another attraction of the showboat Yellow Rose of I'm Texas.
A cap?
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes, indeed.
I'm coming home.
I've got a yearning, home fire's burning.
Darling, don't you cry.
I'm coming
home. Here comes your rover coming home.
I'm coming
home.
I see the light of your eyes so bright, and
I see a clear blue sky.
I'm coming
home. Here comes your rover coming home.
I'm coming.
storm cloud into a warm cloud, climbing each step to you.
I'm coming.
Watching the rainbow bound by the lane glow, climbing to heaven too.
I'm coming.
One little mile more, save me a smile, boy.
You two kids better top this number. Those boys are penny all right, and I know Talon's gonna see it.
You certainly do, Cap.
I'm coming. Here comes your old man coming home.
I'll get him for you if you like.
No, don't bother.
Benny, Roy, they want an encore.
What's the matter, darling?
Cap, I can't go on now. Roy, will you excuse us a minute? I want to talk to Cap.
Roy, send on the next number, will you?
All right.
What?
Just going to.
Well, never mind. Come on.
Oh, my little gal sure has grown up.
Dad, are you all right?
Don't worry about me.
Drop it, Weston. This is quite a surprise, Betty.
But not a pleasant one.
Who is he?
A policeman. Next time, I'll be more careful making friends. I suppose you think I planned all this.
It doesn't matter much now, does it? Ready, Weston?
Take the gun, Betty. Now get around there, mister. And keep your hands up. That's all, brother. Drop it.
You dropped your gun, mister.
Why, you little squirt.
Need your wagon, mister. Shall we get started?
No, you're making a mistake.
Well, I don't think so. He's the one who made the mistake, breaking jail and before that stealing a payroll.
But he didn't steal it. You don't believe that, do you?
Why should I?
The way I'm, Betty. All this guy is interested in is collecting the reward. Say, you're not a regular copper, are you?
No, I'm from the insurance company. But I still have to uphold the law. And after that, I'll expect you to tell me what you did with the money.
Which I haven't gotten, which I never saw.
All Dad wants is to prove his innocence. They framed him. Honestly, they did.
Well, that's not for me to judge.
Well, at least you can listen, Roy. It can't do any harm.
Young fella, we're both looking for the same thing, only for different reasons. If you turn me in, you lose the money, and I lose the last chance to clear myself.
And if I listen to your story, what happens then?
You might change your mind and give us both a break. You game?
All right, Buster. Put down the gun. Make yourself comfortable, Weston. And make the story good. Go ahead.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, it all started 5 years ago right here in Prairie City. Betty and I were strangers. Our idea was to buy a ranch, but needing a little money, I took a job driving for the express company. It was my first night on the job. We had to run a payroll shipment up to the Hollister mine. The express agent sealed the box and turned it over to me and the regular driver, a chap named Charlie Goss. He owns the Club Ace here now. Between us, we carried the box out to the buckboard. Being new on the job, I suggested Goss drive and let me ride guard behind. But for some reason or other, he didn't like the idea.
I ain't supposed to. Your job was to drive.
So we changed places. What's the difference?
Well, none. I mean, I hired out as guard.
Well, you know the road, Goss. I don't. It'll save time.
All right, but stick close.
It was rough going right from the start. I was riding about 20 feet behind the wagon when it happened. Goss fell to the ground unconscious. Shot from under me, the wagon gone with the payroll, and Charlie Goss slugged in the back. Right after that, the sheriff picked me up. Yeah, they gave me a trial, all right. But when Goss testified that I shot him and said I insisted on riding behind, the jury lost no time in hanging the blame on me. Now I'll tell you who I think did it.
I'm way ahead of you, Weston. You think Goss had a hand in it, don't you?
Well, who else? I'll admit he didn't rig it right, or he wouldn't have got shot himself. That slug was intended for me. Somebody was working with him, but that somebody got his signals mixed. They counted on killing me, framing it as a holdup, and then splitting up the money later. But I got a hunch it didn't work out that way.
Not with Goss shot, and the other fellow gone, and the team running away with the money. What do you think happened to that box, Weston?
That's exactly what Dad's been trying to find out, Roy. If he could find that box, it would clear him.
Nobody ever found that box. It's around here somewhere. I don't want to give up now, Rogers. I've got to find it.
That's a pretty big order, isn't it?
Not so big as you think. A couple of weeks ago, Pete here found a piece of the buckboard in the canyon about 5 miles from the place we were held up.
It's true, Roy. Dad wouldn't have broken out of prison if he hadn't had at least a clue. Won't you help us?
All I need is 48 hours.
Suppose I make you a proposition, Weston. You said I need that box as badly as you do, and you're right. If I help you find it, are you willing to remain in my custody and at the end of 48 hours, give yourself up?
You mean whether we find it or not?
Win or lose. If the posse tracks you down ahead of time, I'll have to surrender you. Take it or leave it.
I'll take it. That's a fair proposition, young fella.
Then it's settled. We can leave tonight and start looking by morning. I know a few fellows will give us a hand, too.
You won't regret it, boy.
I hope you're right, Betty.
Ain't found a thing.
The sheriff's coming.
The sheriff?
Yeah, he and his men. I had to come across the ridge to get here first.
You going to surrender me, Rogers?
Well, that was our bargain, but don't jump the gun. We'll see what he wants first. Betty, you better stay here with your father. Come on, Buster.
Are you looking for somebody, Sheriff?
Yeah. And don't try to tell me he ain't around here either. Come on, boys. We'll search this canyon.
before you go ahead with this, I'd like to have a few words with you.
Don't trust them. They're stalling.
No use, Buster. Somebody must have tipped them off.
What are you covering up for? Where did he go?
I can't answer that.
We're wasting time. They're all in it together.
All right, scatter out, men, and bring him in.
He didn't break his word, Roy. He just couldn't let them catch him now.
Where is he?
He's going to meet us at Pete's cabin. He promised. Don't you believe that?
I don't know what to believe.
Signs of Weston, and neither did the sheriff. Looks like our bird has flew the coop.
I can't understand what's happened.
Get my horse, will you?
Well, it's pretty plain to me what happened. Your dad grabbed the first chance he had to run out on me.
I think you're jumping to conclusions.
Have you any suggestion?
Only that you wait and find out what actually did take place.
I think we already know that. Your dad agreed to meet us here. Well, we've waited 3 hours and he hasn't shown up yet.
So you think he let you down?
I certainly do. It's at times like these I get awfully lonesome for those hills we were talking about. Remember?
All set, Roy.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm checking out, Cap.
Oh, now take it easy, Roy. I want to have a little talk with you. Betty told me the whole story. And if you knew that kid like I know her, you wouldn't make such a darn fool of yourself.
I'm afraid if anybody made a fool out of me, it was Betty and her dad.
I think you're wrong.
The point is, I wasn't crazy about having to come here in the first place. It just happened to be my job. Looks like my job's done.
You won't change your mind?
No.
Timber!
Timber! Mountains high, down the canyon wide, let me roam and ride, ride through timber. When the day is done, by the campfire's gleam, let me lie and dream.
Obstructing justice.
If you're looking for Weston, he's not here.
Well, we'll take a look around for ourselves if you don't mind.
Before you do, Sheriff, I'd like to talk to you.
About what?
Well, it concerns this problem right here.
Well, go ahead. I'm listening.
This will have to be in private.
Keep your eyes open, boys.
All right. Does this explain things a little better, Sheriff?
Rogers, why the devil didn't you come to me in the first place? As a representative of the insurance company, you ought to cooperate with my office, not jam me up.
Jamming you up was an accident. I had a hunch, but I was wrong. After listening to Weston's story, I was about convinced he was telling the truth.
Him taking those pot shots at me this afternoon ought to convince you otherwise, does it?
Let's just say I was following the wrong trail. There's just one thing that puzzles me, Sheriff. How did you know that we had Weston down there in the canyon with us this morning?
Got a tip. Somebody tossed this in my window.
Mind if I keep it?
Oh, help yourself, Rogers.
What's that way?
Now you better get my bag and get car and put it back in my room. We're not leaving after all.
Huh? Oh. It's all right, boys. Go ahead.
What's the matter, fellas? Something wrong?
Now take it easy.
Back here.
You said I was in your custody, didn't you?
That was before you took a shot at the sheriff and ran away.
I didn't shoot at the sheriff, Roy. Those shots were meant for me, whether you believe it or not. One of them got me in the arm. I had to make you get away to save my life. If I'd have been doing this, I wouldn't have shot myself, would I? And if I wanted to get away, I wouldn't have come back here.
Who shot you?
Goss, naturally.
Couldn't have been him. He was standing not over 20 feet from me when the shots were fired.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure.
Well, I don't get it.
Neither do I, but I'm going to find out.
Wait. Maybe this will help. Here's the slug I dug out of my arm.
I'll keep this.
Well, what about me?
Take it easy. I'll have somebody look after that arm.
Betty, if you don't think I'm too much of a heel, I want to apologize for this afternoon.
Why?
I was wrong about your dad. You better get some bandages and go back to the stall where Trigger is. He's there. Hey, Buster. I got something I want to tell you. Come on. Hey, Buster. See that guy with Goss?
Yeah, his name's Ferguson.
How long's he been around here?
Born here, as far as I know. Hey, you don't think he could have shot Weston?
Anybody could have done it. Well, he happens to be on Goss's team, and anybody that's a friend of his is sure no friend of Weston's. We've got to figure a way to get a fired slug from his gun. I want to compare it with this one.
Thought I told you to stay out of here.
Oh, did you? Guess I wasn't listening.
Well, you're listening now. Get out of here before you're thrown out. You haven't your gang with you this time.
I wouldn't talk rough to him, Mr. Ferguson. He's a gunfighter.
Gunfighter, huh?
Well, you 2-1. I can outshoot anyone around here.
You got a bet, cowboy. Just 20 says you can't.
I'll hold the money.
I'll take some of that easy money. Here's 10 bucks that says Ferguson can beat you.
Oh, you're going to be sorry.
Now I'll take 5. What's the name of the horse?
How about that barrel down there?
What about the side of the building?
I mean the plug.
All right with me.
Yeah.
whole barrel.
I'll say you did.
That'd be a lesson to you, cowboy.
Yes, sir. Let's get that slug.
Here we are, Lucky.
Now, what was the name of the horse?
Still, I'll get it.
Now you've done it.
Wait a minute,
wait a minute.
Boy, if you ain't a man.
But I got it.
Well,
let's go to the express office.
Hi.
Howdy.
Say, that's a swell-looking shotgun.
Best in the country.
Nice balance. Do you do much shooting?
Every chance I get. What do you think of these?
Nice looking birds, ain't they, Roy?
They sure are. Where'd you get them?
Up in the hills. What happened to you? Did you fall in the river? What can I do for you fellas?
I'd like to ship this box by express.
Sure.
National Insurance Company, Dallas, Texas.
From Roy Rogers. You work for this outfit, Roger?
That's right, but I don't want it generally known around town, if you don't mind.
Don't you worry. Anything that goes through this office is strictly confidential.
Hey, maybe you can be of some help to me. My company's still working on that holdup that happened a few years back. Do you know anything about Goss?
Nothing special. Seems you've done all right financially the past few years. Nobody can dope out where he got the money.
From what I hear, people figure that payroll box was never recovered.
I don't believe that. Any guy slick enough to stage that holdup is smart enough to follow through and get the dough. Of course, I'm only guessing.
So are we.
Here's your receipt.
Thanks.
Can you trace that wagon?
Not a bolt or a sliver.
Wherever it is, it's sure not in that canyon. This is like looking for a needle in a haystack. We better call it a day.
That's two of us for that idea. Make it three.
Oh, howdy, Pete.
You look unlucky.
We are, 100%.
Say, Pinto, that's quite a weapon you got there. A little dangerous, though, isn't it?
No, see, I'll show you. That don't count. Something slipped there.
I see.
Say, was the sheriff still in town when you left?
Some of them supplies out of that wagon.
Okay.
Well, you stay here. Keep out of trouble. Hey, Buster.
Look down there. Looks like the wreckage of an old wagon.
It sure does. Roy, do you suppose that could be the lost wagon?
Could be. Kid could have come this way, hit the same sharp curve and gone over just like Pete did a few minutes ago.
Hasn't been touched yet. Even the seal's unbroken.
Let's break it open and see what's inside.
Never mind. We'll leave it just like it is.
Don't you want to make sure the money's in there?
Not now. I've got a pretty good idea of what's in there. This is neither the time or the place to open it. Come on, we're heading back.
What's behind all this, Joe?
Search me.
Sounds interesting, though.
Going over to see what it's all about?
You might as well.
I think it's just a plain luck to get a bigger crowd at this show.
What do you suppose he's trying to pull? I don't know.
Somebody said Rogers found that strong box.
Hi, Rogers.
Howdy.
Looks like you stirred up some excitement.
Well, I figured the town could use a little.
Hey, you mind telling the guy what you got up your sleeve?
For a buck, sure. You really going to spill something up there tonight? Why don't you come out and see the show? I may take you up on that.
What does he mean, real culprit? Everybody knows Weston's guilty.
Rogers doesn't seem to think so.
Well, I think Rogers is crazy.
Yeah, crazy as a fox. That stunt's going to fill the show books a dollar a head.
Sure.
You know the routine?
Yeah, I got it.
If you got one.
We paid a dollar to find out who robbed the express wagon.
Yeah, give us something for our money.
Where's Rogers?
We want Rogers.
Roy, don't have that surprise.
I'm not going to let you down, folks. The strong box, which was stolen here 5 years ago, has just been recovered. Acting in the interest of my insurance company, I've taken possession of it. I'll give you my reason for this later. But just to satisfy your curiosity and put the after the professor finishes his act, I'm going to ask the sheriff and the committee to come up here and open the box in plain sight. And I believe what we find inside the box will be the surprise I promised you. Search him, Buster. You know what these are, Sheriff?
Sure. They're bullets. What of it?
I'll explain that in a minute. But before I do, I suggest you arrest this man for stealing the money in the payroll box.
Don't listen to him, Sheriff. He's trying to put over a fast one for his company.
Can you back up this charge, Rogers? Sure. Open the box.
All right. Put it over here.
Yeah, Sheriff. You get better?
Yeah.
While you're doing it, you might notice that the express company seal is still intact.
Why, it's empty.
Just as I figured. Funny part about it, Sheriff, there never was any money in that box. Lucas made away with it before it was ever put into the wagon. Then he staged a holdup to cover up. Incidentally, Goss, this is the man that shot you in the back, not Weston.
Well, I'll be...
For a while, I figured you did it. I even thought Ferguson had a hand in it. That's why I wanted to compare the bullet that hit Weston with the one from your gun, Ferguson. Obviously, the comparison was never made, because we just found the bullets on Lucas. I guess he opened the package and substituted his own samples.
You can't prove anything with those slugs. Do you mind letting me take a look at those bullets, Rogers?
Don't anybody move.
Thank you.
will follow us. The people on shore will miss the sun. So when you are sad and don't be down, hold it up blue. Just float on a sugar and watch your dreams come true.
Moonlight on the river and the breeze singing above. When you're on the go-go, time hurries along. Night air fills with laughter as the bow flows to the sun. When you're on the go-go, heaven is your home.
You know, what I'd like to ask you about is, you know, we've talked about different actors and things, mm-hmm. but I remember we were watching a segment of something, like one of the Red Ryder things, and you saw somebody and said, oh, heck, that's so-and-so, he's driving a wagon or something. I mean, there were so many extras.
Mm-hmm. But the horsey people were, there was not a whole bunch of them. And so you got, I mean, there was only like three or four stables that furnished horses for movies. Hutkins and Fat Jones and can't think of them right now, but there was only about four major stables that furnished animals or horses for Westerns. And so there's not that many wranglers and whatever and whatever, so you've got to know everybody. Of course, now, any wranglers that you don't know who they are or anything, you know. But anyway, like I say, we got to where we knew a lot of the horsey people because that's what we did, you know. And back then, there weren't that many. Of course, now there's several outfits that supply horses and stuff for the movies.
Well, like, we'd be watching, and it, like, lots of different movies we'll be watching, and it'll seem like all the horses are kind of the same thing. Like in El Dorado, there's a lot of Appaloosas.
Mm-hmm.
And so, do you know who would probably have been the one providing those horses, supplying those horses?
I have no idea. I've been out of it too long.
But Glenn Randall,
oh yeah,
he was, now was he, did he supply some animals or was he just doing the training and stuff?
He
is
did
that
most of the training, and I mean, he supplied the horses for Ben-Hur. He went out and bought them and trained them and a whole bit, and then he trained for Roy Rogers, he trained for Rex Allen, he trained for Wild Bill Elliott and Alan Lane. Rex Allen, like I say, he found Coco and sold him to,
oh, really?
Bought him and sold him to, well, he bought him for Rex, with Rex's money, I guess. But anyway, he was just the greatest trainer that ever was in the business, and he lived right next door to me, so how could I go wrong, you know?
Yeah. Let's talk about Roy Rogers at home. I mean, you spent some time over at their house and stuff, didn't you?
Oh, yeah.
Because Cheryl and you grew up together.
And we did all kinds of things together. And, of course, Dusty was little bitty then, so, you know, I don't remember him too good. But Linda, I remember her real well because she was a little younger than Cheryl. But Cheryl was more my age, so I would hook the stagecoach and the horses up, and we'd go drive up down the streets and then whatever, on with Shetland ponies.
So did y'all ever play with cap guns?
Oh, yeah.
Play, like scenarios of stage robbing and all that
stuff?
Oh,
yeah, did that, too. That's in my book.
I've seen that picture in your book. I sure have.
But I used to, hook all the on weekends, I'd hook the stagecoach or the covered wagon. We had a covered wagon too.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. And I'd hook them up and we'd just play on it, you know. I mean, we'd have a Indian raid and all that stuff with Glenn Jr. And Linda and Cheryl and me and a couple of kids from down the street, and we'd all get together and we'd ride in the wagons, and it was fun.
Well, that's the kind of thing. See, that kind of fun outside fantasy type playing, kind of acting out what, you know, the stuff that, you know, you'd be seeing on the television or on the movies and stuff. That's the kind of stuff that I'm trying. I get so many emails and phone calls, you know, about grown-ups telling me about what they did, and that's why they're buying cap guns for their kids or their grandkids or something, to get them outside to play. And that's what we're trying to do with the Tales of the Cap Gun Kid videos that we're going to be doing, and Lord willing, we'll capture some of that. And we've already got really good response out of the first one. I appreciate you saying you'll be in one, and we'll get you back into acting.
Okay.
Hope you enjoyed The Yellow Rose of Texas, starring Roy Rogers and Dale Evans and our buddy Don Reynolds. And, you know, it's a real shame that a lot of these movies have deteriorated like they have. I mean, this movie was done in 1944, and it's in pretty rough shape. This is the best copy we could find. But thank God we have the copies we do, otherwise this stuff would have been lost to us forever. We appreciate you. We hope you'll come back and see us. We hope to see you again on down the trail. And like Roy always said, may the good Lord take a liking to you. Y'all have a great day. Howdy, I'm Bob Terry. And welcome to another free Western brought to you here on the internet by Wild West Toys. Up next is a fantastic, fun, exciting Western. It's a Roy Rogers movie starring Roy Rogers, Dale Evans, And our friend Don Reynolds is in it. It's his first movie. The movie's titled The Yellow Rose of Texas. Of course, there's suspense, there's mystery, there's adventure, there's excitement, and some of the best Western music ever done by Roy, by Dale, and by the Sons of the Pioneers. Don is pretty well retired now, lives here in Texas, and he was good enough to come by and talk with us sometimes about different things, and we're going to show, before the movie starts, we're going to show some tidbits with Don about the movie, and make sure that you stay all the way to the end, because after the movie, we're going to talk with Don a little bit more. Don, tell us some more about Roy Rogers, your first movie that you were in. What was the first movie you were in with Roy?
Called Yellow Rose of Texas, and because of me, they found the wreck that had happened a year ago and all the gold and saved the picture.
Well, so you're very important.
Yes. No, I, being a kid, I had a slingshot, and I automatically just shooting around, and I shot a team of horses that was pulling my wagon, and they took off, and then Roy had to run and rescue me, and then the wagon went over the cliff, and that's whenever it did, they went down and found the wreck of the one that had been there years before that supposedly had the treasure on it.
Don, you worked with Roy in how many movies?
I did two movies with him. One, my first movie was with him, and that was called The Yellow Rose of Texas. And then later on, I did a little one-scene thing with him where I roped a calf. I was about 7 or 8 years old at the time. And it was called Song of Arizona. But Roy was almost like a neighbor because his horse trainer, Glenn Randall, lived right next door to us. And so I saw an awful lot of him, and we rodeoed together and whatever. And Roy was just, well, if it hadn't been for him, I wouldn't be here today, because he brought me to California in 1944, or 43, and got me started in movies. And I wound up being the last Little Beaver, and got into the business, basically. I became an animal trainer, and I trained horses for Lord of the Rings. Was my biggest thing I ever did. And anyway, that because of Roy, I would have not done all that. So everything I got, I owe him.
Feeling fine.
Know where we're playing tomorrow?
Yes, I know. Prairie City.
Well, I thought maybe you might not want to face them up there. So I'll put another act in your place and you sort of take it easy, huh?
That's not necessary, Cap. It's been 5 years. They've probably forgotten about it anyway. You've got something else on your mind, haven't you?
It's about your father, Betty.
What about him?
He's broken jail.
Did they get him?
No, he's still out. Happened about a week ago. I read it in the Prairie City paper. I'm sorry, darling, but you have to know it sometime.
I'm sorry, too. You shouldn't have done it, Cap.
Well, there's no use worrying about that now. But you see what I meant when I said about taking the day off tomorrow? Might be a little embarrassing.
Embarrassing? Why should it be?
Well, they're liable to have a little hard feeling about you up there, on account of your father, I mean. And I just sort of figured that...
That's all the more reason I should face them, Cap. We've got nothing to be ashamed of. You think I'd let you down?
Well, as a matter of fact, Betty, what you're doing is exactly what I expected you to do. Now you go and hit the hay, old trooper.
Yes, sir.
Well, you look worried.
Maybe I am, a little. Have you ever been in Prairie City?
No, this is my first trip. You're gonna have to show me around. I sort of dread strange places.
I think I know what you mean. I dread it too.
But I thought you knew the place.
That's just the trouble. I do.
City. Maybe 2 or 3 hours. It's going to be awful hard getting on board until after dark, Mr. Weston.
Tonight will be all right. I'll give you a note. Be sure Betty gets it.
But don't let anybody see you give it to her. Understand?
Get your tickets here for the greatest show that ever hit Prairie City. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Get your tickets here. Camp Rap Post, get your tickets here for the greatest show that ever hit Prairie City. It's just about to start, folks. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Get your tickets here. Just a minute, gentlemen. Get your tickets here.
Official business.
Take over, Lou.
All right, Cap.
All right, folks. Step right up and get your...
You seen anything? Not yet, Sheriff. I know everybody that's come aboard so far.
I still don't think he'd risk coming up here. It's a sucker move.
Weston's no sucker. He's sharp. He figures he'll be safer in the crowd than trying to make it alone. I know that guy.
Well, keep your eyes open, boys.
How many do, sir? Four? Yes, sir. All right, sir. Step right along, please. There's plenty of tickets and plenty of room. Thank you, sir. All right, lady, how many?
So when I left her, it broke her loving heart.
And if we ever meet again, we'll never, never part. She's the rose of rarest beauty this fellow ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may sing of other pretty gals from Maine to Tennessee, but the yellow rose of Texas is the only rose for me.
There's a cowboy back in Texas who said he would be true.
I knew you were from Texas.
Please tell me how you knew.
The way you smile reminds me of the one I used to know.
There's a many a rose in Texas if you're looking where they grow.
There's a cowboy back in Texas.
Well, he's really just a friend. He lived down by the Rio where the river makes a bend.
Well, you know my rose of Texas lives across on the other shore.
So as long as they're together, we won't see them anymore. She's the rose of rarest beauty this fellow ever knew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You may sing of other pretty girls from Maine to Tennessee, but the certain one of Texas is the only.
How do you do, Sheriff? You wanted to see me?
I'd like to ask you a few questions. When did you hear from your father last?
Well, about a month ago he wrote me a letter. But I think I know what you want me to say.
But you tell us.
That I know where he is. I'm sorry, Sheriff, but he didn't let me in on his plans.
You were figuring on seeing him, weren't you?
Absolutely not.
There's no particular reason you should tell us if you did know.
In that case, Sheriff, why do you bother to ask?
Just a minute, young lady. If you know what's good for you, if you want to save yourself from trouble, you talk. And talk fast.
Simmer down, mister. You're getting out of line fast.
You too, cowboy. Suppose you mind your own affairs.
How do you know this isn't my affair?
Please, Roy. I can handle it.
That's an idea. Beat it.
Do you mind? I'd like to talk to the sheriff alone.
You better stay here, Gus.
Long distance, please. I'd like to place a call to Mr. John Ellis, National Insurance Company in Dallas.
Hello, Roy. How are you doing? Did you contact the girl?
Yes, sir. I got a job on the showboat as an entertainer. I have a hunch she doesn't know anything about the missing money, though.
Well, I hope your hunch is wrong, Roy. But handle it your own way. Stick close to her. I still say that she and her father will try to get together. Right.
In a hurry, mister?
I could be. Why?
Nothing. Only it might be a good idea. As a matter of fact, I make a... You leave town right away.
And I second it. You wouldn't want to get that nice shirt all dirty. It's too pretty.
Well, I'm glad you like it. But don't worry about it getting dirty. I have to take things to the cleaners every once in a while.
I like your scarf, too. That's a little uneven.
Hey, bouncer! Bouncer! Faster!
Throw these fellas out of here.
With pleasure, boss. Roy!
Buster!
You old son of a gun, how you been?
Well, how you been?
Here, I said, throw him out.
You mean Roy, Mr. Gorse? I can't do that. He's my pal. I haven't seen him in years.
What's that got to do with it? You're fired.
Come on, baby.
Thank you.
They've been keeping you busy?
Sure, on the move every minute. Take us, Gila Bend, rodeo or two, roundup, all used in Chopper Buster.
It's a great life.
Sure is.
Just a minute. Yes. Hey! Hey! Get me out!
Now, who started this?
Him.
Me?
All right, arrest him.
Which way did they go?
It was mighty nice of you fellas pitching in and helping me like that.
No problem at all.
We couldn't stand by and see one fella gang up on like that.
I guess we better go in and see if the boss is back yet, huh?
Yeah, about our job.
Job?
Sure. Yeah, they sent for us to play and sing in here.
Oh, musicians, huh?
You fellas ain't got any job. That was the boss Roy and I slugged.
What do we do now?
Well, we might as well hightail it back over the ridge where we came from.
Hey, maybe Roy can get you a job in a showboat. How about it, Roy?
All of them?
Well,
wait a minute, fellas. I don't own the boat. I'd like to.
Come on, Roy. We can't let them down. Where's your instruments?
Well, at the express office where we shipped them, I guess.
Well, come on, let's go.
Wait a minute. Where's Shub?
Shub?
Yeah.
Say, you don't suppose he...
Hey! Oh, boy!
Take that thing!
Can't get it off him! Tim! Bob, help me here. Somebody get down with it. Hey!
Let's go get the instruments.
Hey!
We're the Sons of the Pioneers. We came after our instruments.
Yeah, that'll be 480.
Sam, Shub.
Thanks, Shub.
Our banker.
Hey.
Don't beat yourself to death.
Hey, now, wait a minute. Don't tell me you lost all our dough in that fight.
I sure did. It's gone.
Still 480. That's all right, fellas. I'll stake it.
Remember, this is just a loan. We'll pay you back. Okay, pick him up, boys.
Wait a minute, fellas. How about getting your instruments out and playing us a tune? We want to see how good you are.
You mean right here?
Sure.
Well, all right, boy.
I'm coming.
I've been away, but there'll come a day, so darling, don't you cry.
I'm coming.
Here comes your rover coming home.
Howdy, Cap. Hey, what sort of a pitch do you call this?
Pretty good, huh?
Mm. Back to the open, range and rope, and one little gal I knew. Back to the wave and sage and save, and all my love for you.
So, folks, just another attraction of the showboat Yellow Rose of Texas.
Cap?
Oh, yes, 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 indeed.
I'm coming.
I've got a yearning, home fire's burning.
Darling, don't you cry.
I'm coming.
Here comes your rover coming home.
I'm coming. I see the light of your eyes so bright, and
I see a clear blue sky.
I'm coming.
Here comes your rover coming home.
I'm coming.
Out of the storm cloud into a warm cloud, climbing each step to you.
I'm coming.
Watching the rainbow down by the lane glow, climbing to heaven too.
I'm coming. One little mile more, save me a smile, boy.
You two kids better top this number. Those boys are plenty all right, and I know Talon's gonna see it.
You certainly do, Cap.
I'm coming.
Here comes
your
rover coming home.
I'm coming.
Here comes your rover coming home.
Who was that?
I don't know.
I'll get him for you if you like.
No, don't bother.
Eddie, Roy, they want an encore.
What's the matter, darling?
Cap, I can't go on now. Roy, will you excuse us a minute? I want to talk to Cap.
Roy, send on the next number, will you?
All right.
Just going to.
Well, never mind. Come on.
Oh, my little gal sure has grown up.
Dad, are you all right?
Don't worry about me.
Drop it, Weston. This is quite a surprise, Betty.
But not a pleasant one.
Who is he?
A policeman. Next time, I'll be more careful making friends. I suppose you think I planned all this.
It doesn't matter much now, does it? Ready, Weston?
Take the gun, Betty. Now get around there, mister. And keep your hands up. That's all, brother. Drop it.
You dropped your gun, mister.
Why, you little squirt.
Need your wagon, mister. Shall we get started?
No, you're making a mistake.
Well, I don't think so. He's the one who made the mistake, breaking jail, and before that, stealing a payroll.
But he didn't steal it. You don't believe that, do you?
Why should I?
Wait, Betty. All this guy is interested in is collecting the reward. Say, you're not a regular copper, are you?
No, I'm from the insurance company. But I still have to uphold the law. And after that, I'll expect you to tell me what you did with the money.
Which I haven't gotten, which I never saw.
All Dad wants is to prove his innocence. They framed him. Honestly, they did.
Well, that's not for me to judge.
Well, at least you can listen, Roy. It can't do any harm.
Young fella, we're both looking for the same thing, only for different reasons. If you turn me in, you lose the money, and I lose the last chance to clear myself.
And if I listen to your story, what happens then?
You might change your mind and give us both a break. You game?
All right, Buster. Put down the gun. Make yourself comfortable, Weston. And make the story good. Go ahead.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, it all started 5 years ago right here in Prairie City. Betty and I were strangers. Our idea was to buy a ranch, but needing a little money, I took a job driving for the express company. It was my first night on the job. We had to run a payroll shipment up to the Hollister mine. The express agent sealed the box and turned it over to me and the regular driver, a chap named Charlie Goss. He owns the Club Ace here now. Between us, we carried the box out to the buckboard. Being new on the job, I suggested Goss drive and let me ride guard behind. But for some reason or other, he didn't like the idea.
I ain't supposed to. Your job was to drive.
So we changed places. What's the difference?
Well, none. I mean, I hired out as guard.
Well, you know the road, Goss. I don't. It'll save time.
All right, but stick close.
It was rough going right from the start. I was riding about 20 feet behind the wagon when it happened. Goss fell to the ground unconscious. Shot from under me, the wagon gone with the payroll, and Charlie Goss slugged in the back. Right after that, the sheriff picked me up. Yeah, they gave me a trial, all right. But when Goss testified that I shot him and said I insisted on riding behind, the jury lost no time in hanging the blame on me. Now I'll tell you who I think did it.
I'm way ahead of you, Weston. You think Goss had a hand in it, don't you?
Well, who else? I'll admit he didn't rig it right, or he wouldn't have got shot himself. That slug was intended for me. Somebody was working with him, but that somebody got his signals mixed. They counted on killing me, framing it as a holdup, and then splitting up the money later. But I got a hunch it didn't work out that way.
Not with Goss shot, and the other fellow gone, and the team running away with the money. What do you think happened to that box, Weston?
That's exactly what Dad's been trying to find out, Roy. If he could find that box, it would clear him.
Nobody ever found that box. It's around here somewhere. I don't want to give up now, Rogers. I've got to find it.
That's a pretty big order, isn't it?
Not so big as you think. A couple of weeks ago, Pete here found a piece of the buckboard in the canyon about 5 miles from the place we were held up.
It's true, Roy. Dad wouldn't have broken out of prison if he hadn't had at least a clue. Won't you help us?
All I need is 48 hours.
Suppose I make you a proposition, Weston. You said I need that box as badly as you do, and you're right. If I help you find it, are you willing to remain in my custody and at the end of 48 hours, give yourself up?
You mean whether we find it or not?
Win or lose. If the posse tracks you down ahead of time, I'll have to surrender. Take it or leave it.
I'll take it. That's a fair proposition, young fella.
Then it's settled. We can leave tonight and start looking by morning. I know a few fellows will give us a hand, too.
You won't regret it, boy.
I hope you're right, Betty.
Ain't found a thing.
Oh. Oh. The sheriff's coming.
The sheriff?
Yeah, he and his men. I had to come across the ridge to get here first.
You going to surrender me, Rogers?
Well, that was our bargain, but don't jump the gun. We'll see what he wants first. Betty, you better stay here with your father. Come on, Buster.
Are you looking for somebody, Sheriff?
Yeah. And don't try to tell me he ain't around here either. Come on, boys, we'll search this canyon.
Before you go ahead with this, I'd like to have a few words with you.
Don't trust them. They're stolen.
No use, Buster. Somebody must have tipped them off.
What are you covering up for? Where did he go?
I can't answer that.
We're wasting time. They're all in it together.
All right, scatter out, men, and bring him in.
He didn't break his word, Roy. We just couldn't let them catch him now.
Where is he?
He's going to meet us at Pete's cabin. He promised. Don't you believe that?
I don't know what to believe.
Signs of Weston, and neither did the sheriff. Looks like our bird has flew the coop.
I can't understand what's happened.
Get my horse, will you?
Well, it's pretty plain to me what happened. Your dad grabbed the first chance he had to run out on me.
I think you're jumping to conclusions.
Have you any suggestion?
Only that you wait and find out what actually did take place.
I think we already know that. Your dad agreed to meet us here. Well, we've waited 3 hours and he hasn't shown up yet.
So you think he let you down?
I certainly do. It's at times like these I get awfully lonesome for those hills we were talking about. Remember?
All set, Roy.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm checking out, Cap.
Oh, now take it easy, Roy. I want to have a little talk with you. Betty told me the whole story. And if you knew that kid like I know her, you wouldn't make such a darn fool of yourself.
I'm afraid if anybody made a fool out of me, it was Betty and her dad.
I think you're wrong.
The point is, I wasn't crazy about having to come here in the first place. It just happened to be my job. Looks like my job's done.
You won't change your mind?
No.
Timber! Timber! Mountains high, down the canyon wide, let me roam and ride, ride through timber. When the day is done, by the campfire's gleam, let me lie and dream.
Obstructing justice.
If you're looking for Weston, he's not here.
Well, we'll take a look around for ourselves, if you don't mind.
Before you do, Sheriff, I'd like to talk to you.
About what?
Well, it concerns this problem right here.
Well, go ahead. I'm listening.
This will have to be in private.
Keep your eyes open, boys.
All right. Does this explain things a little better, Sheriff?
Rogers, why the devil didn't you come to me in the first place? As a representative of the insurance company, you ought to cooperate with my office, not jam me up.
Jamming you up was an accident. I had a hunch, but I was wrong. After listening to Weston's story, I was about convinced he was telling the truth.
Him taking those pot shots at me this afternoon ought to convince you otherwise, does it?
Well, let's just say I was following the wrong trail.
There's just one thing that puzzles me, Sheriff. How did you know that we had Weston down there in the canyon with us this morning?
Got a tip. Somebody tossed this in my window.
Mind if I keep it?
Oh, help yourself, Rogers.
What's that way?
Well, you better get my bag and get car and put it back in my room. We're not leaving after all.
Huh?
Oh. It's all right, boys. Go ahead.
What's the matter, fellas? Something wrong?
Now take it easy.
Back here.
You said I was in your custody, didn't you?
That was before you took a shot at the sheriff and ran away.
I didn't shoot at the sheriff, Roy. Those shots were meant for me, whether you believe it or not. One of them got me in the arm. I had to make you get away to save my life. If I'd have been doing this, I wouldn't have shot myself, would I? If I wanted to get away, I wouldn't have come back here.
Who shot you?
Goss, naturally.
Couldn't have been him. He was standing not over 20 feet from me when the shots were fired.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure.
Well, I don't get it.
Neither do I, but I'm going to find out.
Wait. Maybe this will help. Here's the slug I dug out of my arm.
I'll keep this.
Well, what about me?
Take it easy. I'll have somebody look after that arm.
Betty, if you don't think I'm too much of a heel, I want to apologize for this afternoon.
Why?
I was wrong about your dad. You better get some bandages and go back to the stall where Trigger is. He's there. Hey, Buster. I got something I want to tell you. Come on. Hey, Buster. See that guy with Goss?
Yeah, his name's Ferguson.
How long's he been around here?
Born here, as far as I know. Hey, you don't think he could have shot Weston?
Anybody could have done it. Well, he happens to be on Goss's team, and anybody that's a friend of his is sure no friend of Weston's. We've got to figure a way to get a fired slug from his gun. I want to compare it with this one.
Thought I told you to stay out of here.
Oh, did you? Guess I wasn't listening.
Well, you're listening now. Get out of here before you're thrown out. You haven't your gang with you this time.
I wouldn't talk rough to him, Mr. Ferguson. He's a gunfighter.
Gunfighter, huh?
Well, you're 2-1. I can outshoot anyone around here.
You got a bet, cowboy. Just 20 says you can't.
I'll hold the money. I'll take some of that easy money. Here's 10 bucks that says Ferguson can beat you.
Oh, you're going to be sorry.
Now I'll take 5. What's the name of the whore?
How about that barrel down there?
What about the side of the building?
I mean the plug.
All right with me.
I'll get it.
Now you've done it.
Wait a minute. Stop.
Boy, if you ain't a man.
But I got him.
Well. Let's go to the express office.
Hi. Howdy. Hey, that's a swell looking shotgun.
Best in the country.
Nice balance. Do you do much shooting?
Every chance I get. What do you think of these?
Nice looking birds, ain't they, Roy?
They sure are. Where'd you get them? Up in the hills. What happened to you? Did you fall in the river? What can I do for you fellas?
I'd like to ship this box by express.
Sure.
National Insurance Company, Dallas, Texas.
From Roy Rogers. You work for this outfit, Roger?
That's right. But I don't want it generally known around town, if you don't mind.
Don't you worry. Anything that goes through this office is strictly confidential.
Hey, maybe you can be of some help to me. My company's still working on that holdup that happened a few years back. Do you know anything about Goss?
Nothing special. Seems to have done all right financially the past few years. Nobody can dope out where he got the money.
From what I hear, people figure that payroll box was never recovered.
I don't believe that. Any guy slick enough to stage that holdup is smart enough to follow through and get the dough. Of course, I'm only guessing.
So are we.
Here's your receipt.
Thanks.
Can you trace that wagon?
Not a bolt or a sliver.
Wherever it is, it's sure not in that canyon. This is like looking for a needle in a haystack. We better call it a day.
That's two of us with that idea. Make it three.
Hello. Howdy, Pete.
You look unlucky.
We are, 100%.
Say, Pinto, that's quite a weapon you got there. A little dangerous, though, isn't it?
No, see, I'll show you. That don't count. Something slipped by.
I see. Say, was the sheriff still in town when you left?
Supplies out of that wagon.
Okay.
Well, you stay here. Keep out of trouble.
Hey, Buster. Look down there. Looks like the wreckage of an old wagon.
It sure does.
Roy, do you suppose that could be the lost wagon?
Could be. Kid could have come this way, hit the same sharp curve and gone over just like Pete did a few minutes ago.
We hit the jackpot.
It hasn't been touched yet. Even the seals unbroken.
Let's break it open and see what's inside.
Never mind. We'll leave it just like it is.
Don't you want to make sure the money's in there?
Not now. I've got a pretty good idea of what's in there. This is neither the time or the place to open it. Come on, we're heading back.
That's a hot one.
What's behind all this, Joe?
Search me. Sounds interesting, though.
Going over to see what it's all about?
You might as well.
I think it's just a plain lot to get a bigger crowd at this show.
What do you suppose he's trying to pull?
I don't know.
Somebody said Rogers found that strongbox.
Hi, Rogers.
Howdy.
Looks like you stirred up some excitement. Well, I figured the town could use a little. Hey, you mind telling the guy what you got up your sleeve?
For a buck, sure.
You really going to spill something up there tonight? Why don't you come out and see the show? I may take you up on that.
What do you mean, real culprit? Everybody knows Weston's guilty.
Rogers doesn't seem to think so.
Well, I think Rogers is crazy.
Yeah, crazy as a fox. That stunt's going to fill the show both a dollar a head.
Sure.
You know the routine?
Yeah, I got it.
I'm not going to let you down, folks. The strong box which was stolen here 5 years ago has just been recovered. Acting in the interest of my insurance company, I've taken possession of it. I'll give you my reason for this later. But just to satisfy your curiosity and put the after the professor finishes his act, I'm going to ask the sheriff and the committee to come up here and open the box in plain sight. And I believe what we find inside the box will be the surprise I promised you.
Search him, Buster.
You know what these are, Sheriff?
Sure. They're bullets. What of it?
I'll explain that in a minute. But before I do, I suggest you arrest this man for stealing the money in the payroll box.
Don't listen to him, Sheriff. He's trying to put over a fast one for his company.
Can you back up this charge, Rogers?
Sure. Open the box.
All right. Put it over here.
Yeah, Sheriff. He's just better?
Yeah.
While you're doing it, you might notice that the express company seal is still intact.
Why, it's empty.
Just as I figured. Funny part about it, Sheriff, there never was any money in that box. Lucas made away with it before it was ever put into the wagon. Then he staged a holdup to cover up. Incidentally, Goss, this is the man that shot you in the back, not Weston.
Well, I'll be...
For a while, I figured you did it. I even thought Ferguson had a hand in it. That's why I wanted to compare the bullet that hit Weston with the one from your gun, Ferguson. Obviously, the comparison was never made, because we just found the bullets on Lucas. I guess he opened the package and substituted his own samples.
You can't prove anything with those slugs.
Do you mind letting me take a look at those bullets, Rogers?
Don't anybody move.
have a gay time, a holiday time. It will be playtime for everyone. Encore will follow encore. The people on shore will miss the song. So when the song on dawn be done, haul it off blue. Just float on a showboat and watch your dreams come true.
Moonlight on the river and the breeze singing a song. When you're on the showboat, time hurries along. Night air fills with laughter as the bow flows to the song. When you're on the showboat, heaven is your home.
You know, what I'd like to ask you about is, you know, we've talked about different actors and things, mm-hmm. but I remember we were watching a segment of something, like one of the Red Rider things, and you saw somebody and said, oh, heck, that's so-and-so, he's driving a wagon or something. I mean, there were so many extras.
Mm-hmm. But the horsey people were
there was not a whole bunch of them. And so you got, I mean, there was only like three or four stables that furnished horses for movies. Hutkins and Fat Jones and can't think of them right now, but there was only about four major stables that furnished animals or horses for Westerns. And so there's not that many wranglers and whatever and whatever, so you got to know everybody. Of course, now, any wranglers that you don't know who they are or anything, you know. But anyway, like I say, we got to where we knew a lot of the horsey people because that's what we did, you know. And back then, there weren't that many. Of course, now there's several outfits that supply horses and stuff for the movies.
Well, like, we'd be watching, and it like lots of different movies we'll be watching, and it'll seem like all the horses are kind of the same thing. Like in El Dorado, there's a lot of Appaloosas.
Mm-hmm.
And so do you know who would probably have been the one providing those horses? Supplying
I have
those
no
horses?
Idea. I've been out of it too long.
So, but Glenn Randall.
Oh yeah.
He was now. Was he? Did he supply some animals, or was he just doing the training and stuff?
He
is
did
that
most of the training? And I mean, he supplied the horses for Ben-Hur. He went out and bought them and trained them and a whole bit. And then he trained for Roy Rogers. He trained for Rex Allen. He trained for Wild Bill Elliott and Alan Lane. Rex Allen, like I say, he found Coco and sold him to,
oh, really?
Bought him and sold him to, well, he bought him for Rex, with Rex's money, I guess. But anyway, he was just the greatest trainer that ever was in the business, and he lived right next door to me, so how could I go wrong, you know?
Yeah. Let's talk about Roy Rogers at home. I mean, you spent some time over at their house and stuff, didn't you?
Oh, yeah.
Because Cheryl and you grew up together.
And we did all kinds of things together. And, of course, Dusty was a little bitty then, so, you know, I don't remember him too good. But Linda, I remember her real well because she was a little younger than Cheryl. But Cheryl was more my age, so I would hook the stagecoach and the horses up, and we'd go drive up down the streets and then whatever, on with Shetland ponies.
So did y'all ever play with cap guns?
Oh, yeah.
Play like scenarios of stage robbing and all that stuff?
Oh, yeah, did that too. That's in my book.
I've seen that picture in your book. I sure have.
But I used to, you know, hook all the on weekends, I'd hook the stagecoach or the covered wagon. We had a covered wagon too.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. And I'd hook them up and we'd just play on it, you know. I mean, we'd have a Indian raid and all that stuff with Glenn Jr. And Linda and Cheryl and me and a couple of kids from down the street, and we'd all get together and we'd ride in the wagons, and it was fun.
Well, that's the kind of thing. See, that kind of fun outside fantasy type playing, kind of acting out what, you know, the stuff that, you know, you'd be seeing on the television or on the movies and stuff. That's the kind of stuff that I'm trying. I get so many emails and phone calls, you know, about grown-ups telling me about what they did, and that's why they're buying cap guns for their kids or their grandkids or something, to get them outside to play. And that's what we're trying to do with the Tales of the Cap Gun Kid videos that we're going to be doing, and Lord willing, we'll capture some of that. And we've already got really good response out of the first one. I appreciate you saying you'll be in one, and we'll get you back into acting.
Okay.
Hope you enjoyed The Yellow Rose of Texas, starring Roy Rogers and Dale Evans and our buddy Don Reynolds. And, you know, it's a real shame that a lot of these movies have deteriorated like they have. I mean, this movie was done in 1944, and it's in pretty rough shape. This is the best copy we could find. But thank God we have the copies we do. Otherwise, this stuff would have been lost to us forever. We appreciate you. We hope you'll come back and see us. We hope to see you again on down the trail. And like Roy always said, may the good Lord take a liking to you. Y'all have a great day.